Greetings, y'all. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade, back playing some more Farming Simulator 17. Getting the harvesters out of the shed, you know what that means. Time for another harvest. We are going to harvest soybeans. So where do we want to start? Well, I'll tell you what, we'll go down this way. We'll start from the west part of the map and just work our way kind of to the east, maybe. And I'm totally not going the right way, am I? I'm going to go this way. It's going to take forever to get these harvesters moved out here. Probably the entire episode. No, I'm just kidding, guys. So, update. We own field 4 and field 15 now. Just purchased them recently. We got in good with Mr. George Turner. Pretty nice fella. He's of Hispanic background. He makes great tacos. But anyway, I'm thinking about food again, guys. Can you tell? But anyway, Mr. George Turner, he's a really nice guy. He owned that field 4 and 15 back there. And guess what they were planted in? Soybeans. So, pretty excited about that. Oh, he also owned field 7. We bought field 7, too. Forgot about that one. It's right up here by 6. We're going to plow those together, actually, once we get them harvested. We're going to go over to our big field. Remember our project we had going on over here at 12 and 11 way over here? Well, we finished it and we got it planted. Soybean is planted over there. We've got a big soybean harvest. That's what all the fields are planted in. So guess what we're going to harvest? Soybeans. That's a shocker, right? But anyway, we're going to get... this slow crawling combine. Good grief, is it slow. 14 miles an hour. Come on, combine. Come on. You can do it. We'll get it down here and get it started somewhere. Probably need to get it started on that side that has that rock on it. I'm for real, y'all. This may be the entire episode moving these harvesters down here. I probably should have went ahead and moved them. Next time I will... So I'll tell you what, I'm just going to start him down here on this side, since he's closer down here. Let's see. Right in here, I guess. I actually need to cut some in rows. Well, that's not what I wanted to do. Pick that back up. Unfold the harvester. That's what I wanted to do. Now, let me cut some in rows here first. I think I'm going to have to. So yeah, we got this entire field plowed. Can you see way over there? Way over there. You can't even see the sheep. Can't even see the sheep area over there. Just a little building that's out there. But yeah, all this, we got it all plowed together. So it's all soybean. You can see where that kind of goes in over there where that rock's at. What I'm going to do, I'm going to get him down to the end here and hire him out and go get the other harvester. Hopefully I'll be back in time to catch him. I think we did a pretty good job. We got all these trees cut up here and plowed this up. And I mean, because this was all trees and just grass up here. Now we got it plowed up to get a higher yield off this crop. We could plow all the way to the road, I guess, if we wanted to. But we kind of want to keep them straight, too, for some hired workers, so... Because they get kind of confused when it comes to curves. Wouldn't it be nice if they didn't, though? If the hired workers could follow the curves that you set around the field? They need to make that a mod, where you can, like the Follow Me mod, where you can kind of set the parameters of the field, even curves and stuff, and then it could just, you know, on program, just go and cut that little bit. This up. I'm going to get him out here a little far. It looks like there's some that come out a little bit. Just a little bit. Alright, I'm going to hire that out and go get the other harvester. Hopefully this guy goes faster. All right, how fast do you go, sir? Yeah, he goes faster. 20 miles an hour. Sure beats the, what, 13 or 14 the other one was going. So, yeah, I think the next guy we want to get in good with is Mr. Watson. He has some pretty good-sized fields. Like I said, Mr. Turner, he's got 25 down there. It's a pretty big one. It might be the biggest field on the map. 25 and 24 run a pretty close race, I think, being the biggest ones. And 13's in there, too. But I don't know. Which one looks bigger, y'all, 13 or 25? Maybe 13. Just a little bit. But Mr. Watson, I think he has some of these fields up here, and we could plow all this together and make it a big field. So got to figure out something with these wind turbines. We're going to leave some roads. We have to leave right of access to these wind turbines. We could plow all around them there. I don't think there's any rocks out here in these fields. We got to cut all those trees down, though. So, where do I want to go with this guy? Need to get over there where that rock's at and get harvest around that rock. Don't want to hit the traffic. Probably need to cut some in-rows down here, too. Need to get my mowers and my rake from the shop there. All right, let me unfold. Let me get around this rock here, and that way we can avoid hitting it with the workers. So yeah, something happened. I hired out the seeder. And I guess he picked up on that little bit. See how there's a little triangle on this field? I'm going to grass that in. But I think he picked up straight out from that rock, because it had gone straight out. And since he already had it planted, I decided to go ahead and leave it. But I definitely need to come back and grass it in. See that little wedge that comes off of that straight line? There's supposed to be a straight line right here. Supposed to go straight that way, but he kind of went on out there, so I decided, well, he's already planted it, I'll just go ahead and leave it. Uh-oh, my other guy's getting full. Let me hire this out. I need my tippers. Come on, tractor, start up. And yeah, I'm still on the standard tippers. I don't have an auger wagon yet. Hopefully that'll change soon. But we'll just run these for now. Come on, tippers. They got a lot of windmills. But yeah, I have to leave access to these windmills, so I may leave this road here and then plow those two fields together or something. Oh, there's another one up there. Is it on the other side of the road? Yeah, it looks like it's on the other side of the road. Good. Alright, he has a full grain tank. I'm coming, buddy. Fast as I can go. 32, 33, 30, something. Take my covers off. And can I beat the truck? Can I beat the truck? Can I beat the truck? Truck, truck, truck. Yep. He only slowed down a little bit. Okay. I'm going to have to get in him and turn him around here. Whoops, not what I wanted to do. $8,600 is his capacity. We'll be upgrading him soon. Or at some point. Here comes the other harvester. He's moving right on across the field there. Now hopefully he'll turn to the right. Hopefully. Don't really want him turning to the left. If he does, he may hit that rock. But he's getting it. Yeah, it looks like he went that way, so I think we're good. He's getting full, though. He's getting up to, he's up to 40%. It's kind of a sharp embankment there on that hill. It's kind of funny seeing crop like that, but hey, it worked. It grew. That's all that matters. Alright, he's ready to go. So we'll hire this back out. And is he gonna turn? Yeah, he's turning that way. So I'll catch him on the flip side. Because his pipe is gonna be towards the crop. And we'll just stay with this one for now. Ooh, jackknife. I don't think he'll fill up. He should be good until he gets down there. Cruise control down. Alright, let me catch back up here. Alright. Now that's a pretty sight. Got our harvest going finally. Might have been a mistake to put that big head on there though. Come on, buddy. Come on, go forward. See, he's got that bigger head on him. Makes it harder to get close to him to offload. Even though I wasn't really that close. See, I'm not that close to him and he's still catching. May just be this tipper or the tractor. Maybe the wide tires or something. I don't know. There's like less than a foot. If I can stay like this, I'll be all right. Now, see, he keeps getting blocked. Come on, buddy. Keep harvesting. I'm not in your way. Even though he thinks I'm in his way, I'm not. We're just, bottom line, just gonna have to upgrade that harvester, get the longer pipe out there with the big harvester. That head's just too big for the pipe, even though the pipe's out there. He's stupid. He just thinks I'm in the way. Maybe he's not sitting high enough to see that I'm not. I don't know. Alright, we're good to go here. We'll get this other guy. So yeah, I kind of made a... error without knowing I made an error. I plowed under my road to the sheep. You can see it there. Gonna make a new road. May make it straight from the shop, just on the corner of the shop there, straight this way. Come on, tractor, let's go. Give me your pipe, sir. I know you're getting full. There we go, that's a whole lot better. See, I'm not in his way. He's emptying into me. Helper B has a nearly full grain tank. Is this Helper B? This has to be Helper B, right? Yeah, I'm unloading him. He's fine. Stop shouting at me. So yeah, we got plenty of soybeans to harvest. Hopefully we can hold them all back at the homestead. I didn't think about that. Oh well, we'll find out. May just have to sell them. Looks like we got a great demand over at the seaport for something. What we got a great demand for? Look real quick. Oh, barley? And see, that's what we mean by the great demand. See, the great demand is for less than what the beer place, well, I don't know how you say that word. Beer. Where is that at? See, it's up there close by it. I mean, you might as well take it there. You get a dollar more. So, we're not going to sell just on great demands anymore. I mean, if the great demand is for a price that's higher than what, you know, all the other places are asking, yeah, we might go ahead and sell it there. But, I mean, what I've seen so far is that the prices are manipulated, or not manipulated, wrong word. The prices are based on, I guess, supply and demand, really. If we have more soybeans or something like that, and we sell soybeans, then the demand for canola is going to go up because there's, you know, they got plenty of soybeans. So, but this is our soybeans now, I think, is the cash crop in Farm Sim, at least this version. So, we'll go with soybeans. Boy, I mean, it's going to be beautiful to plow all that together down there. Still got to leave roads to the windmills, but looks like they're mostly, for the most part, either by main roads that we're using or kind of spaced out towards the highway, so that's good. That means we only have to leave a little road to them. I'm not blocking you, sir. Oh well, I'm just gonna stop you. If you're not gonna go, I'm just gonna stop you. Even though I'm not blocking you. I don't know why he has such a Helper J. I'm gonna fire this Helper J. Yeah, I am not blocking him. Not one bit. I don't know if the tires are not in the way. Look, I am not blocking him. He's got plenty of space to go. Go, go, go. Maybe it's just that tipper. I don't know. I am not blocking. Yeah, we gotta trade him up. Soon as possible, we gotta trade him up. How much is that combine? That's the one. No, wait a minute. That's the one we have. That's a small one. That's the big one. $398,000. He's worth $220, really? All right. Try it again. Come on. Empty. Empty. There you go. Stay away from his head. Oh, that's full. I know it looks like it's dumping out, but it's not. It's dumping into it. All right. You're good and empty. You're fine. Yeah, that's a number one priority before the next field. Get a combine. All right, this front one's full, so I'm gonna put a cover on it. So, oh no. And this guy's probably gonna fill this one up, so. Let's see, 42,000 liters is the cutoff. Well, maybe he's not gonna fill it up. Wish he would have. I could have gone to the end of this and gone and emptied. All right, well, we'll continue this soybean harvest and get it all cut and come back and do something else, I'm sure. We'll probably work around field four over there. We got a lot of trees over there, and I think we can plow around that and make that field a little bit bigger, bring it on up to the homestead a little bit. So until then, guys, remember, you reap what you sow. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade. See you guys next time.